Springtime had arrived on the island of Sodor. A fair had come to town, and the children were having a marvelous time enjoying the rides. All the engines were at their busiest, carrying folk to and from the fairgrounds. One day, Daisy pulled into Ellsbridge. She was collecting passengers who were on their way to the fair.
I've heard from some of the engines that the line in the fairgrounds are on has a ghost train, she said. What is all the chanting about it anyway?
It's a tunnel that small trains run through, said her driver. There are skeletons, ghosts, and other spooky things in it.
Small trains like Scarlowy? Daisy asked.
No, chuckled her driver. Not like Scarlowy.
Thank goodness I don't have to go down there then, murmured Daisy. I'd be too scared.
Henry was just pulling in with a passenger train and had overheard Daisy.
Huh, he scoffed. I'm not scared of things like that. Only little engines are scared of ghosts.
I wouldn't be too sure about that, my dear, chortled Daisy. Didn't an elephant once scare you out of a tunnel?
Henry took no notice. That afternoon, Henry stopped at Edward Station to drop off a goods train. Ollie and Edward were there, resting.
This talk about a ghost train is all over the island, she said. Normally, something like this would be discussed near Halloween.
Edward smiled.
It definitely helps to pass the time on a hot day like this, as well as keep some engines' wits about them at night. You'd never know when some owl would hoot and bring about trouble.
Ha! I'm not scared of ghosts, Henry boasted,
although, secretly, he'd hope he'd never get the chance to meet one. Just in case. Later, Henry was resting at the sheds. He was just about to settle in for the evening when his driver returned unexpectedly with bad news.
Wake up, Henry! Part of the roof of a tunnel near the fairgrounds has collapsed. The fire controller wants us to take a work crew to clear the rubble right away, he said.
Bother, grumbled Henry.
I was looking forward to a rest.
Cheer up, lad, his driver laughed. It's not exactly hard work.
Well, at least it'll keep me away from all this banter about ghosts,
Henry groaned.
Best to take a lamp with you tonight, Henry, said Duck.
Aye, tunnel is darker at night without one. Not the best for looking out for ghosts without one.
Oh, be quiet, snapped Henry. Even if there were such things as ghosts, it's only the little engines who are scared of them.
And with that, he popped out of the sheds. Henry did not have a cheerful journey to the tunnel. The trucks teased him as they went along the line.
Henry's scared of the ghost train, lads,
jeered one.
Yeah, he's right spooked, he is!
Yelled another. Henry ignored this and steamed on without a care. Soon, they reached the tunnel, and Henry puffed cautiously inside. Things were going well. The workmen had cleared up what rubble they could. When they had boarded, Henry started reversing back out of the tunnel.
What in the Fat Controller's name was that? Exclaimed Henry.
His driver got down to look.
Well, that's done it. Your tender's derailed. Rubble must have fallen behind us. We can't go forward nor backward.
The guard went to find a telephone to call for help. When he came back, it wasn't good news for Henry.
I'm afraid help can't come till morning, Henry, said the guard. You'll have to stay here for the night.
Brilliant, wheezed Henry. That's all I need.
When the driver, fireman, guard, and workman went home, Henry was left alone with the trucks, who, by this point, had fallen asleep. Quite soon, he had begun to doze too. And eventually, he fell asleep. All of a sudden, Henry woke with a start. He could feel himself moving forward, and the trucks and guards van had disappeared. It was then Henry realized he had no driver or fireman.
What is all this? He asked in horror. Some sort of joke?
No reply came, rather a haunting noise. Then a ghostly shape flew towards Henry, snarling as it went past him.
Ah!
Cried Henry. His wheels shivered as he puffed along through the swirling fog. In the distance, Henry could see a station ahead. He felt relieved, until he saw what was on the platform.
A skeleton staff, ghostly passengers, and what seemed to be a very thin controller.
Get me out of here!
Wailed Henry as he sped along, panic-stricken. But the tunnel seemed to go on for miles until he rounded a curve. Suddenly, Henry stopped. He could hear a familiar whistle in the distance.
Sounds like Gordon, he said. Oh, thank goodness.
Henry saw a glimmer of light approaching fast, but he had completely forgotten that he was standing on the same track. Then, from around the bend, a ghostly Gordon rushed towards him with a scream and a roar. Henry could bear it no more. He whistled long and loud.
No more! No more!
He shouted.
No more!
All of a sudden, Henry felt himself moving out of the tunnel.
Wake up, Henry, the driver called. Your tender's back on the line. We can go home now.
Henry was delighted to be out of the tunnel. He hurried home as fast as he could, pleased to see the morning sky. Some of the engines were still at the sheds when Henry returned.
Ah, there you are, said Duck. You were gone for longer than any of us expected.
Did you see any ghosts? Teased James.
Henry tried to sound as brave as he could.
I said I didn't believe in ghosts. Therefore, no.
But we all know what Henry saw in his dream that night, don't we?